David Bosio from Shaw & Partners. David, good morning. Good to see you.
Morning, Andrew.
Look, David, the gold price come off its highs, but still performing well. Are we seeing a fair bit of buying from retail investors?
Yeah, it's very interesting. We've seen a decent pullback now from, I guess, the initial rally in gold price, which coincided with the initial commencement of the invasion of Ukraine. We saw gold price rallying up through 2050 around those levels. Now it's come off. It's around 1930, 1940 at the moment, where it looks like it's made a bit of a base. But very interestingly, yesterday we saw 7 change of substantial notices in some of the gold majors. And all of those changes were increases in holdings, and that was from Van Eck. Now, for many investors who do follow these gold markets, they would know that Van Eck manages the GDX gold ETF. And that means that essentially they're buying in, the gold ETF is increasing its exposure to these gold companies. Again, all major gold companies, which tells you that there's probably been an influx of retail mum and dad investors and institutional investors for that matter, saying we want to increase our exposure to gold. How's the best way to do that? Let's buy an ETF. And the ETF manager, being Van Eck, then goes into the market and acquires additional units in those companies. So I would say, based on those substantial shareholder notices that have come out, coincidentally, 7 of them yesterday, that there's been a flurry of buying from the retail investors and then, I guess, the broader investment community in the sector.
Why do you reckon that is? Why are retail investors looking to up their exposure?
Oh, I think there's two main themes that I'd touch on here. Real interest rates. So we've talked about this many, many times. There's a correlation between an increase in gold price and real interest rates. Now, real interest rates continue to decline. Real interest rate, it's important to know the difference. Interest rates are rising. However, inflation is rising at a higher rate. So we've seen massive inflation globally already. Now that means that real interest rates are actually falling. So the real value of money continues to decline. That's a positive for gold. It enhances the value of gold. So I think that's something there where people are saying this inflation is a real concern. And although interest rates are going up, I'd rather have my money sitting in gold, something that's got some real intrinsic value. That's one thing. And then secondly, obviously, with the Ukraine-Russia, call it war invasion, there's been a real move to, I guess, more defensive assets and assets such as gold that seem to thrive or at least benefit in times of uncertainty and conflict, for example. So I think they're two main things that have brought the investors back into the gold market.
David, just while I've got you this morning, we've got the news here, BHP demerging their energy business to Woodside. What are the implications for investors?
Yeah, so the BHP demerger or sale of its energy assets has been out in the marketplace for some time, but there's a few key things here which I think many investors are yet to really get their head around, and I think it's important to start to be aware of this, which is BHP have essentially sold their energy business to Woodside, and in doing so, BHP investors will receive a Woodside share as well as a franking credit or portion of Woodside shares for every BHP share based on a successful outcome at a shareholder meeting toward the end of April. So again, it's contingent on shareholder approval. But in the event that this does go ahead, our analyst has looked at it and believes that this will represent potentially around a 10% additional dividend yield, because BHP shareholders will receive a part share in Woodside as well as a franking credit. So really, it's a mechanism that BHP are using to use up some existing franking credits, but also to give an enhanced return to its shareholders. So if you looked at it as a yield play, over and above the current yield, which is quite substantial, it's still around 4 or 5% for BHP, you would potentially receive a distribution of Woodside shares and franking credits that almost equates to, you know, depending on the day and depending on the share price, around another 10%. So I think investors looking at this as a trading opportunity will start to see BHP as something certainly worth looking at, but quite interesting. A few other things to be wary of as well, or conscious of, is the fact that BHP recently voted to cease its dual listing. So they have now shut down that UK listing, and it is it will be subject to re-weighting. So it now represents a bigger portion of the Australian market, which means that there's still a lot of rebalancing as Australian institutions and global institutions, for that matter, that follow the Australian index will be accumulating potentially more BHP to meet the rebalancing and the increase of BHP as a percentage of the Australian market. So there's a few key things there to be wary of and potentially take advantage of in terms of BHP going forward.
Good to get your insight. David, thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.